Right, so I'm ready to trim this teardrop shaped bottle. For a small opening, you need to have the chuck to hold it so that you will be able to trim the bottom. So I have two chucks because one of my chuck is too short, so I stack it up to make it a little bit taller so my vase, my bottle can fit it in here. And also my chucks are bisque, so it's hard for the bisque chuck to hold when you are using the clay coil to hold it. It's hard to get it stick. So before I trim my pot, if you have the bisque chuck, usually you might want to soak it in the water. And I have been soaked both pieces in the water, so now the clay is easier to stick because it's not absorbing water anymore. Alright, so the rest of that I will just show you in time-lapse mode, so you will save time to watch them. Alright, so to recap what I have done. First, I turned it upside down and put it on the chucks and trimmed the foot. And then I put the black slip and then did the chattering. And then after I removed the chuck, I turned it upside down, flip over, and then trim the curb, make it a little bit nicer. And then I brush the subscrofetal, brush this black slip again to cover it all the way up to here. And then I did the chattering here and chattering here. So I was using my number one, okay? This is number one, designed it for get the chattering mark easier, okay? And then after that, I used the scofidal tools. So here are my scofidal tools, okay? I was using the large one, the largest one for the larger gap, and then the medium one to cover out the smaller line in the middle. So I have three different sizes, small, medium, and large. I was using a large and the medium one to cut the straight lines. Okay, so that's the what I have done. And this piece of clay is around, before I started, it's around 3.5 pounds. Okay, 3.5 pounds. I'm sure this will be less than 3 pounds now. It's very time consuming, but it's very nice piece after the scofidal nice. All right, hope this helped, and see you next time.